today or tomorrow is expected to see official statements regarding those here without visas due to the visa amnesty, which is set to end at the end of the month. With tales of 1 month's extension in Bangkok and 1 week in Chiang Mai, nothing is set in stone yet. And we're told the results of the committee meetings will be released soon. The word, though, is that the amnesty will officially end on the 31st, and application for proper visas or extensions of stay need to be filed as quickly as possible to avoid any problems. Either that, or book a ticket to get yourself home. As the nation reels from the news of two violations of COVID regulations for arrivals here, Rayong is reported to have seen its trade and hotel bookings drop to close to zero, as people are concerned after the Egyptian army team left their set residences and wandered the city, mostly unmasked, and subsequently at least one developed the COVID virus. Pattaya too is said to have seen bookings cancelled for some hotels, as fear of the Chinese virus remains an issue here. Governors of all provinces around the nation have been asked to assist anyone who visited the city at the same time as the Egyptian crew. And in Nakhon Ratchasima, three people are in isolation after developing flu-like symptoms following a stay in Rayong. It's been clarified that they've not been diagnosed with COVID-19, and this is a precaution. A meeting between the Egyptian embassy and Thai authorities yesterday saw the embassy apologize for the incident but not report on either the condition of their crew or what, if any, disciplinary action would be taken against them for the violations of the conditions of their visit. And further military flights from Egypt have now been banned. China has suspended two flight routes from Bangkok for 2 weeks. This after they claimed that at least six passengers tested positive for COVID-19 on recent flights. No further news on this. But as Thailand has seen zero cases of the Chinese-based virus reported in the past months, an investigation is underway here. Discounts for Thais travelling within the nation are now freely available as of yesterday. The We Travel Together website is up and running. Thais only can apply and get discount codes to use for accommodation and more during trips out of their province. Over 1,000 hotels and restaurants are taking part in that scheme so far. Meanwhile at home, and as Pattaya's mayor has confirmed, last week's flooding was exacerbated by pump failures, which are now being rectified. Drainage, at least on Beach Road, did work well though, seeing little in the way of beach erosion after what was the heaviest of monsoon storms so far this year. Many projects, we're told, were put on hold during the COVID scare, but have since resumed operation and are underway. A view of Pattaya and Jomtien beaches yesterday saw perhaps only a dozen people on the sands in total during the day, as beach chairs had been removed from Jomtien's seafront, so the popular sands were almost empty. The weekend will no doubt see an influx of beachgoers from Bangkok, but weekdays for sure are not what they normally are. And finally, as we continue to receive donations to our Help the Hungry appeal for Pattaya, so the Fab 103 Fund will this week pass on cash to the Soy 7 team in Jomtien, who feed close to 1,000 every Friday. Your money will fund a whole day's handout from the team, who've been giving away food for several months. Other funds too, as they come in, are passed on to those who are doing great work in the city. And to make a difference, visit gogetfunding.com and search for Fabulous 103. With the reminder, mitts, masks and meters, wash your hands, wear a mask and keep social distancing, and the Met Office promising highs today of 30 degrees dropping down to 26, and the guarantee of storms at any time. That is the local and national news from Fab FM. For videos and, of course, to keep up with Fabulous Pattaya, visit alwayspattaya.com.